For decades, scientists have plugged away at one of the most widespread and detrimental diseases there is, Alzheimer's. But a research team in the UK believes they've reached a turning point.
Nerve cell death is the hallmark of Alzheimer's disease, and this chemical may be able to prevent that neurodegeneration from happening, therefore potentially stopping Alzheimer's disease in its tracks.
The hope for something like this is that we are able to arrest the process of cell death, of brain cell death, and that's what's so exciting.
This chemical is the first drug ever to prevent the death of brain tissue. The initial experiments were on mice, but researchers say making this available for humans is the next step. This graph shows the process. The disease activates a natural defense in the body that switches off protein production, causing brain cells to die off. That's the Alzheimer's disease. This new chemical, in mice at least, blocks the off switch, allowing the body to produce protein again, which effectively stops the killing of brain cells. But researchers are quick to caution that nothing is cured yet, and there is plenty of work to do. The test was done on mice, and the chemical cured prion disease, which, although very similar, is not Alzheimer's. One neuroscience professor, though not involved in the study, says prion disease is very rare in humans and is not yet clear if the same approach will be viable for much more common neurodegenerative conditions like Alzheimer's disease. More research is needed to determine if this approach is valid for any condition other than prion disease. The other problem listed by researchers are the serious side effects that come along with this chemical. The compound affected the pancreas as well as the brain. This led to a mild form of diabetes and significant weight loss. The study was published Wednesday in the journal Science Translational Medicine. The group behind the study says a drug for humans is at least 10 years away, but they remain excited about the turning point in their research. For Newsy, I'm Jasmine Bailey.